White House in Washington, top defense officials of the nation gather to discuss the gravest world crisis since Poland and Pearl Harbor. The flagrant aggression of Chinese communist troops in Korea arouses the country's ire. With the North Korean bandits well under control and with the promise that UN troops would be withdrawn, the unexpected entry of 300,000 red Chinese across the Manchurian border may well precipitate World War III. President Truman voices his accusation of red imperialism.
The forces of the United Nations are in Korea to put down an aggression that threatens not only the whole fabric of the United Nations, but all human hopes of peace and justice. If the United Nations yields to the forces of aggression, no nation will be safe or secure. If aggression is successful in Korea, we can expect it to spread throughout Asia and Europe and to this hemisphere. We are fighting in Korea for our own national security and survival. We have committed ourselves to the cause of a just and peaceful world order through the United Nations. We stand by that commitment.
On the battlefront in Korea, United Nations forces fight desperately to meet the red attack. Here our troops must face what General MacArthur has termed a new war. Outnumbered more than 2-1 by Chinese and North Koreans, the UN forces hope to regroup and to meet the overwhelming attack which has broken their fluid lines of defense across Northern Korea. The President has stated that the use of the atomic bomb is being considered to halt the communist onrush inspired by Russia. His hope is that the employment of this devastating weapon will be unnecessary, but the final hope lies with the United Nations. At a momentous meeting at Lake Success, the Red Chinese delegation from Peking hear themselves charged with every crime on the calendar of aggression by Ben C. Lim, representative of the Republic of Korea. While Mr. Lim talks, the delegation, whose hordes are threatening world peace, refuse to take their seats and face their accuser.
I point my finger at these representatives of the Chinese communist regime, and I ask, why do they come here with unclean hands? I ask again, why does this group come here with the hands that drip with blood? The blood of the United Nations troops, the blood of the Korean people.
Blocking a United Nations motion to order communist Chinese armies to leave Korea, the Russians used three vetoes. On each of the votes, Russia's Jacob Malik was the only dissenting voice. The United States, represented by Chief Delegate Warren Austin, took up the debate and further accused the Chinese Reds of aggression in Korea.
It is no exaggeration to say that that problem is the gravest one now confronting the world. That problem is this: will there be peace or war in the Far East? The world awaits anxiously the answer to this question.